Let's determine the molecular geometry of HCN. This is hydrogen cyanide. So we start with a valid Lewis structure. This is our Lewis structure. If you need help, there's a link at the end of this video, how to draw the Lewis structure for HCN. So we can see that the central carbon is bonded to hydrogen, and then it's bonded to the nitrogen there. So it's bonded to two things. That's its steric number. And there aren't any lone pairs, any unbonded electrons around the carbon. Zero lone pairs. Molecular geometry, that's going to be linear. Let's take a look at that in three dimensions. So the purple, that'll be the carbon. We'll put our hydrogen on there, and then we'll put our triple bonded nitrogen. And you can see they spread out to be as far away as they can from each other. There aren't any lone pairs on the central carbon here. Our molecular geometry is linear. The bond angles, they're going to be 180 degrees. Let's go back to our Lewis structure. So with that steric number of 2 and no lone pairs, we have that linear molecular geometry. You could also use the AXE notation to figure out the molecular geometry. A is the central atom, that's the carbon. X, that's the number of atoms bonded, 1, 2. And then E, that's the number of lone pairs. There aren't any, so you could write E0, or you could just have AX2. If you look this up on a table of molecular geometries, you'll find that the molecular geometry for AX2 is linear. This is Dr. B with the molecular geometry for HCN, hydrogen cyanide. Thanks for watching.